Hi friends, so today I'm going to explain you about the internet protocol, like IP concept, like in addressing. So in this video I'm going to explain you about the IP address classes, network ID, host ID, what is octal, in one octal equal to how many bits. So all those things I'm going to cover today video. So I'm just requesting you, all of you, please watch this video till end so you can easily understand the IP concept, because I'm going to explain you step by step. Okay, fine. So let me go to the diagram. Okay, so you can see here I mentioned IP like addressing, and there you can see it's I mentioned physical address and logical address. It means, you know, like in addressing there are two types of addressing. One is a physical address, the second is a logical address. When we are talking about physical address, it means we are talking about the MAC address. Okay, and MAC address is also, it's a 48 bits. Okay, when we are talking about the logical address, it means we are talking about the, you know, IPv4 and IPv6. This is a logical address. So, you know, like MAC address, you know, so MAC address is by default one name is assigned to a particular system, that is a MAC address. And logical address like IPv4 and IPv6, like we are assigning, you know, particular some IP to particular device, you know. So then like we are assigning manually that one. Fine so like IP full form you know, right? IP full form means internet protocol. So this is the IP full form. Okay, internet protocol. So just I'm going to highlight one thing here, you know. In a network we can reach one device to another device with the help of IP. How we will reach to one device to another device, you know, in a network through the IP. So there, in that time, IP will help you to reach to one device to another device. Okay, fine. Now let me tell you one thing, just one most important things you have to keep it in your mind, you know. When we are talking about the logical address, you know, it means total size is, you know, logical address total size is 32 bits. Just you have to remember these things. 32 bits and 4 octal. I will tell you what is a octal, but you have to just remind these two things. When we are talking about the logical address, it means like when we are talking about the IPv4, you have to understand like IPv4 total size is 32 bits and it's a 4 octal. Okay, and this also, it's a combination of 0 to 255, you know. In every octal, because there is a 4 octal, right? So in every octal, in minimum and maximum value 0 to 255 you can use, minimum to maximum every octal. Fine, now let me come to the another point here. So like, you know, when we are talking about the IP address, you know, so how IP address is creating. So let me tell you one thing here. Suppose I am taking one IP here, 192.168.223.05, for example. I am taking this IP, you know. So how this IP created, you know. So you have to understand how IP is a creating. So IP, when we are talking about the IP, you know, so IP creating with the two things. One is a network ID plus host ID, you know. So this when IP is creating with the this combination network ID plus host ID, then IP is creating. Okay. So in a later I will explain you what is network ID, how can you identify like a network ID or host ID. You know, I will explain you that one. Okay. Fine. So now one thing you can see now here. So this IP is a, you can see here IP, it's a 192.168.223.05. So you can see, let me diagram here first one thing. 1 minute. Octal 1. Octal 2. Why I'm writing here, I will explain you. Then you can easily understand. Octal 3 and octal 4. Fine. So you can see I mentioned here octal 1, octal 2, octal 3, octal 4. So when you seeing this IP, you can see before dot, this is a 1 octal, you know. Before dot, this is a 1 octal. 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 So total octal is, you can see 4 octal. 1, 2, 3, 4. I mentioned here, right? 4 octal. When we are talking about a logical address, it means 4 octal. You can see it's mentioned 4 octal. And every octal, now, you know, one thing here, in every octal, it's 8 bits. Every octal, it's 8 bits. Every octal reads 8 bits. Every octal equal to 8 bits. Value equal to 8 bits. Okay. Now, if you add this 888, you know, now you can see it's a total bit is 32 bits. You can see now total equal to is 32 bits. So logical address 32 bits, 4 octal. Now I hope you understand. So when we are talking about a logical address, it means 32 bits and 4 octal. So you can see, for example, this is IP. In this IP, you can see 192.168.223.05. So before dot, 192 is 1 octal, 168 is 1 octal, 223 is 1 octal, and 05 is 1 octal. And each octal equal to 8 bits. The value is 8 bits. This value is 8 bits. You can see 8 bits. So equal to 32 bits. So total size is 32 bits. You have to remember these things. When we are talking about logical address, means total size is 32 bits and 4 octal. You never seen, you know, like IP like this. You never seen like IP like this. 192.168.223.05.09. Not, you never seen IP like this. Whenever IP is coming like this, okay, it's a 4 octal. Okay, fine. So now let me explain you about the first class, you know. Okay. So there is a 5 class, you know, in IP address. Let me diagram here. So, you know, so there is a 5 class. So, class A. So, in a class A, you know, so like a value, you know, starting with the 1.0.0.0 to 126.0.0.0. So this is the value, you know, in a class. When we are talking about the class A, so in a class A, IP, you know, starting with the 1.0.0.0 to 126.0.0.0. When we are talking about the class B, so class B value is starting with the 128.0.0.0, okay, to 191.255.0.0. When we are talking about the class B, so value starting with the 128 to 192.255.0.0. Okay. Now class C IP. So you know class C IP is starting with 192.0.0.0 till 255.255.0. So this is a class C IP. When we are talking about the class D, so you know class D IP is starting with 224.224.239. Okay. Class E. When class we are talking about the class E IP, it's starting with the 240 to 255. Okay. So you can see there is a total 5 class in IP. So class A is starting with 1 and till 126. Class B is starting with the 128 to 191. Class C is starting with the 192 till 223. And D is starting with 224 to 239. And class E is 242 to 255. So generally, you know, this two IP we are not using. Generally, this two IP we are not using. Why? Because class D using the multitasking. Class D IP is using for the multitasking, and the class E IP is using for the research and development. Okay. So these two IP we are not using. Generally, we are using only these three IP: A, B, and C. When we are talking about the class IP, it means it's a big network. When we need to a big network, then we can use the class A IP. When we are used like a big network, then we can use the class A IP. If you a small network, then you can use the for class VIP. Okay. Now you can see all the IPs are here. It's a coming a sequence: 1 to 126, 128 to 191, 192 to 223, 244 to 239, and 242 to 255. But one IP is missing here. You can see. So like you can see, where is 127? Because you can see it's a one is starting with the 1 and it's coming 126, but 127 is not here. Now you can see it's starting with one directly from 128 to 191. Here 192 it's coming. Oh, here you can see 124 is coming. You can see here 40 is coming, but 127 is not showing here. So I can say 120 127 IP is also it's a reserve IP. It's a assigning to the system to check that their network network cards are working or not. So it's a reserve IP. Okay, I can say it's a reserve IP. So in a reserve IP, we are calling that also loop back address. Okay, we are calling also it loop back loop back address. So this is a I can say reserved kind of IP. Okay, fine. So now you can see, let me give you some example here, so then you can easily understand. Now I'm mentioning here 125 dot something like that, 0.0.0, something like that. So you can see this IP belongs to which class. So you can directly, you can easily find, right, this IP belongs to class A. You can see, because 1 to 128, class A. Now suppose if I giving 183 to dot 0.0.0. So for example, you can see now this IP belongs to which class. You can see it's a class B, because class B IP is starting with the 128 to 191, and my ID is starting with the 183. It means class B. So you have to check only the first octal, and then you have to identify this IP belongs to which class. No need to worry about the rest of the part. Just check the first octal, and then you can identify this IP belongs to which class. Suppose now I am giving here 192, okay, dot 168 dot 223 dot 10. Okay, for example, I am giving. So you can see now this IP is belongs to which class. So you can easily find, right, because 192 is starting with the 192. It means it's a class C. It's a class C, because class C IP is starting with the 192. So you have to check only the first octal. No need to worry about the rest of the part. Check the first octal, and then you can easily identify this IP belongs to which class. Okay. So this is the IP. These are the IP. Let me give some IP here, like for the understanding. I'm taking one IP here, 192.168.223. For example, I'm taking 10. Okay, so this is the one I have, one IP. Now question is, now you know how we will I can say it's a find this from the, this IP, like how we will find what is network ID and what is the host ID, you know. So how we will find this one? Okay, so I think I will come with another video for this part, because it's otherwise it video will be too long. So I will come with this explanation, like how we will find the network ID and then subnet, rest of the things I will come with another video. So I hope you understand this concept, like, you know, so how you will relate, like suppose someone give the one IP and they will asking, you know, tell me though, this IP belongs to which class. So now I think your concept is clear. You directly will take the first octal, and then you can relate, oh, my IP, this IP is belongs to this class. And then you know, like you also understand now, IP is, you know, creating with the combination of network ID and host ID. And then each octal you 8 bits. So because total, when we are talking about the logical address, it means total size is 32 bits. How it 32 bits? Because there is a 4 octal. In a 4 octal, every octal size is 8 bits. So that's why 32 bits. And you know, this IP you'll see also is a decimal part. So it's because the computer is not understanding, like, you know, when you are giving any data like RAM 192, computer not understanding that things. Computer only understanding the binary language, right? So it's converting to the binary. So I will explain you in another video, you know, that one. So because this is the decimal data, this is decimal data. So how it's coming 192, how like that 8 bits, you know, how it's 8 bits coming. So all those things I will explain you in the next video. Okay. So thanks for your watching. So please subscribe my channel, comment, share it. Thank you. Thanks.